Welcome to WP Beginner. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add an email link in WordPress. Specifically, I'll show you two ways to do this quickly and easily. But keep watching because we'll also talk about why you might not want to add these email links to your WordPress website. To get started, let's go ahead and head over to our website. We want to log into the WordPress dashboard. So add admin to the end of your website. It'll bring you to your login screen where you can log in. All right, from here, we need to decide, do you want to create an email link in your post or a page? Let's say we're dealing with a post and we want to add something to it. I'll pick my Hello World post to add something. Adding an email link is very similar to adding a regular link in your website, where you highlight the area, click insert, and from here you can type in the HTTP or the HTTPS, and you add the address, click add link, and now you have a hyperlink to a website. So adding an email link, click insert. I'm going to expand the whole thing. When doing an email link, you simply use the mail to prefix instead of the HTTP or the HTTPS. And this is a valid email link on your website. The second method of adding an email link, it's useful if you want to add an email to, say, the sidebar or somewhere in your WordPress theme. You'll want to actually type out the HTML code for it to work. I'm going to go to our little text editor area. I'm going to highlight the code and we want to copy this. You can either click Command or Control C to copy or right click and click copy. So you'll have it in your clipboard so you can use it. Let me update the post and then let's head over to Appearance, Widgets, because we'll add the email link to our sidebar area. I'm going to scroll down to find the text widget. And I'll add that to my sidebar. Paste in the code from the post and click save. And now we have an email link on our sidebar area. All right, now that I've shown you how you can add the links, let's discuss why you might not want to. For one, adding the email link becomes publicly visible. And this makes it easy for email bots to scrape your site, collect your email, and then you start getting a ton of spam. The second thing to think about is that users are less likely to switch from using their browser that they're using to view your site to switching over to using their email client to send the email. They're just not going to bother doing it. Instead, you want to use a contact form on your website, and we recommend using WP Forms. Did you learn something helpful from today's video? If so, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button right here. And thanks for watching.